remember now. I remember everything. We used to be humans. Normal humans. Just a bunch of regular human kids like you'd see anywhere. And then we came here. They wanted to turn us into weapons. So they used magic to perform terrible experiments on us. Eventually they succeeded. They managed to create a perfect weapon. The name of that weapon was Number 6. But soon they lost control of Number 6, and the experiment was deemed a failure. They had to create a weapon that could petrify Number 6 and seal it away. So they created me. I'm Number 7. I'm a weapon.
Weapon or no weapon, you're still a meal to us.
Thank you. This is Number 6. She's my sister.
This thing is alive.
My sister is the greatest weapon ever made, and...
Yes, go on.
And with her power, I could eradicate my petrification curse.
So what's the plan here?
First, you have to promise me something.
Hmm?
If my sister somehow manages to swallow me up... My original self becomes lost. I'm afraid I may try to hurt all of you. And if that happens...
No! Wait!
Then I want you to kill me.
You have to get him out of there, now!
I'm on it. I'm not gonna lose anyone else. Things way too quick.
Hurry, there's still time to save him.
I know there is.
Magic is the only way to damage this one. Stay your weapons. Such attacks will hurt Emil as well.
How is magic any different?
He is highly resistant to it.
Then let's kill that thing with magic and get Emil out of there!
Shield your weapon. A physical blow would doubtless harm the boy. We must use magic to... defeat this beast.
Emil, we're coming for you!
Come back to us. Are you all right?
I'm still alive! I feel my sister's power inside me! I think I can control my abilities now!
Yes, we're all quite pleased. Now get out here already!
Just a second. I can't see very well. No! Don't! Don't look at me!
Emil, what's wrong?
Stay back!
Good God. Welcome back, Emil. You've been through a lot.
But my body... I can't stand to be with you when I look like this.
What'd I tell you? We're here for you. No matter what. Can you see my face?
You look just like I thought you would. You look really cool.
Right.
I think I'm okay now. If this is how I look now, then so be it. I was terrified at first, but it's not all bad, you know? I have the magic I wanted, and I can use it to bring Kaine back to us.
Emil.
We should hurry. She's waiting. I sure hope seeing me doesn't petrify her. You know, in fear?
I see this transformation has not stolen your terrible sense of humor.
Whenever I interacted with Kaine, I was reminded about something from my past. Maybe my mind has been confusing her with my sister this whole time. Anyway...
The beast approaches.
Oh, I know.
Must have. How did it even survive these past 5 years?
I'm not gonna let this happen again. It dies today! I saw it feels lighter.
It's not the blade, but the skill of the user. Strike it down!
Alive. Alive. Stay alive. Stay alive. Stay alive.
Grandma.
Kaine, you gotta live. You gotta come back to us.
Closer to finding her. We need a way to locate the Shadow Lord.
By the way, this is for you.
Is that a lunar tear?
It's not as good as your grandmother's, but I tried.
No, it's great. Thank you.
Kaine waking from her long petrified sleep. Emile's unflagging kindness. Our reunion was a happy one. We let it wash over us like rain. That is, until Devila and Popola had to go and ruin it all.
Are you kidding me? You can't be serious!
Please, try to understand. People are tired and scared, and... I'm sorry. I'm sorry you have to bear the brunt of that.
This is crap, and you know it!
It's okay. We can sleep outside.
No one's sleeping outside. You and Kaine saved this village. And now they want to run you out?
People are afraid of us. And really, I understand. I mean, look at me. As long as you're still with us, I can deal with it. Right, Kaine?
I'm used to sleeping outside.
But...
We'll see you later.
Sorry about this.
What is the matter?
Kaine always sleeps outside. I never thought about that until just now. Never even occurred to me. Damn it.
We should turn in.
I didn't get much sleep that night. For the first time in my life, I hated Devila. For the first time in my life, I doubted Popola. But those feelings are pointless in the end. They said and did what they did for the sake of the village. Protect it from the horror of the shades. Really, how can I blame Devila and Popola? In the end, I'm just as bad. Because I never once stopped to think about Kaine and Emile's situation myself.
Sleep well?
Sure.
And yet your red eyes tell a different tale. Don't be so hard on yourself, lad.
I need to go see Devila and Popola.
Very well.
Hey.
Hi. I kinda thought you'd never talk to us again.
I understand you're doing this for the village. And that you don't have a choice.
Pretty much, yeah. But look, why don't you go talk to Popola? I think she wanted to discuss the Shadow Lord with you.
I'm headed there next. Oh, and Devila?
Yeah?
Sorry about yesterday. I shouldn't have lost my temper like that.
You don't need to apologize. Anyone would be upset when their friends are hurting. Let Emil and Kaine know that we're sorry, all right?
All right. Popola?
Oh, hello.
Look, I want to apologize for yes-
Stop. You didn't do anything wrong.
Yeah, but neither did you. You're just trying to protect the villagers. And I jumped down your throat for it.
It's very kind of you to say so. Regardless, please don't let it trouble you.
Ahem. I believe there was something you wished to discuss with us.
Oh, right. Yes, about that. You know about the lost shrine, right?
The temple where I was first discovered.
That's it. Well, it seems that the Shadow Lord's lair is connected to it somehow.
Oh-ho. It was right under our pages the whole time.
But the bridge that leads there is unusable.
So, take a boat.
A boat?
Yes. The canal's finally been repaired. It took a lot longer than expected. What with the shades and all. I also asked them to provide a boat at the path to the Lost Shrine's back entrance. The ferryman will let you use it free of charge. That should make it easier for you to move from town to town.
Thanks, Popola. I feel like you've done so much for me. I'm really grateful. All right. I'll see you around.
And for the love of everything, be careful.
The path above the entrance to the shopping district should lead to the boat landing.
How excellent to know the canal is finished. Hopefully this puts our days of running all over behind us.
The faster we can move, the faster we can save Yona. Let's use it as often as we need.
You have better luck finding the thieves than I did. Shop here more often.
Thanks for... Thanks,
everything in working order.
Yeah, Weiss. I'm good.
Your health is diminished. Do be more careful next time,
hmm?
look who it is! Remember me?
That red bag. By my pages, you're the slovenly half of that couple who refused to stop arguing.
Hey, it's been a while.
Sure has. I've been in charge of this canal since we last talked. Apparently I did a pretty good job with it because they decided to make me the permanent ferryman.
Oh yeah, huh? Congrats.
Thanks. Still, it's not all puppies and unicorns. The old ball and chain is always harping on me now about how much I work. Anyway, if you got a place to be, just let me know and I'll take you there. Lost Shrine's up ahead, just past this cave.
As well as the Shadow Lord's castle.
Let us make haste. This is all too easy.
Thank you.
Kaine? Emil? Look, from now on, I'm going to sleep outside with you.
Why?
I can't accept that you aren't allowed in the village. It's stupid.
So you're staging a protest? Have fun!
Don't waste your time.
But it just feels wrong.
Well, that's really nice of you, but you still don't have to stay out here with us.
Emil.
You got a super important mission. You can't sleep out in the rain. What if you catch a cold? Besides, I like camping with Kaine. Sometimes we sit around the fire and tell stories, or roast...
Emil, that's enough. I got a fucking image to maintain.
Seem to be surrounded by a mob of helpless puppies.
Just kick them aside.